I knew a simple soldier boy who grinned at life in empty joy, slept soundly through the lonesome dark, and whistled early with the lark. In winter trenches, cowed and glum, with crumps of lice and lack of rum, he put a bullet through his brain, and no one spoke of him again. When World War I broke out in 1914, Siegfried Sassoon was recruited to fight for the British Army. On the Western battlefront, he was recognized for his valiant and life-saving feats. However, after being exposed to the brutal war environment, Sassoon removed himself from the war and started writing remarkable poetry on the gruesome conditions. In his poetry, he raised awareness of the soldiers' harsh situations and took a stand against government decisions to extend warfare. He informed the public on what he thought was wrong and inspired many other poetic writers of his time. World War I started with a bang, literally. The assassination of Archduke Franz Ferdinand of Austria by a Serbian nationalist is considered the starting point of the Great War. From there, things escalated quickly. 2 days after Austria declared war on Serbia, Russia started to mobilize. Mobilizing means to start preparing troops and weapons for war. Germany, an ally of Austria, warned Russia to stop mobilizing. Russia, who wanted to prove their strength, declined. Germany then declared war on Russia. The same day, France started to mobilize, so Germany declared war on France and later Belgium. Germany's invasion of Belgium caused Great Britain to declare war on Germany. Already, in the first week of World War I, there were 7 countries involved. Later, many other big powers such as Japan and the United States would join. Sassoon was 28 when Great Britain joined the war. He came from a rich Jewish family, and like many other men from his time, he wanted to fight for his country. Sassoon was assigned to the Sussex Yeomanry and served on the Western battlefront in Europe. The battlefront was so brutal that he would never think the same again. World War I brought with it many new inventions, such as the machine gun, tank, and chemical weapons. These lethal instruments made warfare more dangerous and destructive than it has ever been before. At the end of the war, the death count was about 17 million, two-thirds of that from battlefield combat. Included in the fallen soldiers was Siegfried's brother, Hamo Sassoon, and the fellow war poets Rupert Brooke and Wilfred Owen.
When I was a child, I heard voices. Some would sing and some would scream. You soon find you have.
Sassoon was recognized as a war hero. On July 1916, he was awarded the Military Cross, which read, "For conspicuous gallantry during a raid on enemy trenches, he remained 1.5 hours under rifle and bomb fire, collecting and bringing in our wounded. Owing to his courage and determination, all the killed and wounded were brought in." However, Sassoon didn't want to be associated with war anymore. He had witnessed horrible and gruesome things on the battlefront and lost friends, family, and loved ones. Later, in 1917, Sassoon would throw away his medal into the River Mersey. After being injured and taken out of combat, Sassoon wrote a letter taking a stand against the continuation of war. It was called "Finished with War, A Soldier's Declaration," and read, "I am making this statement as an act of willful defiance of military authority because I believe the war is being deliberately prolonged by those who have the power to end it. I am a soldier, convinced that I am acting on behalf of soldiers. I believe that the war upon which I entered as a war of defense and liberation has now become a war of aggression and conquest. I have seen and endured the suffering of the troops, and I can no longer be a party to prolong these sufferings for ends which I believe to be evil and unjust. I am not protesting against the conduct of the war, but against the political errors and insincerities for which the fighting men are being sacrificed. On behalf of those who are suffering now, I make this protest against the deception which is being practiced upon them." In this letter, Sassoon is saying 3 main things. 1, wars should be fought for a valuable purpose. 2, wars should not be continuously drawn out for years on end. 3, people at home should not feel satisfaction from war because they have never experienced the brutality of it.
When authorities read Sassoon's letter, they tried to shut it down. To win the war, they must try to keep spirits high instead of promoting messages against war. However, many soldiers and officers had already heard Sassoon's words and secretly agreed with them. They were afraid to speak out because many soldiers had already received brutal punishment for deserting.
To further get his point across to the public, Sassoon wrote remarkable poetry about the war. He didn't hold back when describing the horrifying details and imagery of it. He was one of the many poets at the time who kept alive the anti-war movement. An especially impactful poem by Sassoon is called Aftermath. It is written in the perspective of a soldier after the war has ended. The soldier's life has been changed forever, and he will never forget what he saw. Do you remember the dark months you held the sector at Mametz? The nights you watched and wired and dug and piled sandbags on parapets? Do you remember the rats and the stench of corpses rotting in the frontline trench, and the dawn coming, dirty white and chill with the hopeless rain? Do you ever stop and ask, is it all going to happen again? The public was shocked when they read Sassoon's poetry. Why would an honored war veteran come out against war? Sassoon was placed in a hospital for mental trauma, but his impact had already been made. Sassoon wrote over 150 poems about the Great War and influenced many other poets and writers. The most famous World War I poet, Wilfred Owen, was a friend of Sassoon when he died in battle. Although these determined poets did not stop the war, they brought light to the horrible and gruesome warfare and fighting. World War I led to the eventual ban of chemical weapons because of their devastating effects. Sassoon's goal was to inform the public about how truly destructive war is. He wanted the world to know that war changes men for the rest of their lives, either mentally, physically, or emotionally. Not only did Sassoon protest against popular belief, but he did it without violence. His use of literature to take a stand relates to many other famous examples such as Thomas Paine or Frederick Douglass. Sassoon knew that protesting with violence would only lead to more war, exactly the thing he was trying to stop. When World War I started, Great Britain had just come from a period of great wealth and fortune called the Edwardian Years. Becoming a global empire had raised spirits and set a feeling of happiness and optimism. This mentality carried over as countries all across Europe deployed troops for war. People were excited to go out, fight, and die for their country. War wasn't viewed as a bad thing yet. It was viewed as an opportunity to prove one's country was better than all the rest. Before World War I, wars were mainly fought with cavalries or groups of soldiers on horses. The new technology allowed fighting to become more extreme and more deadly.
I came across a Cornishman. He was ripped from his shoulder to his waist. Shrapnel. He was laying there in a pool of blood. As we got to him, he said, shoot me. He was beyond all human aid.
This new type of fighting was something that had never been seen before. As death counts rose to the millions, the sense of optimism and happiness disappeared, and a new modern era had begun. The new era consisted of different views on war. With the help of war poets, people could understand the devastation caused by modern warfare. In the future, wars such as the war on ISIS will be more carefully planned out and executed with regard to soldiers' lives.
As Commander-in-Chief, my highest priority is the security of the American people, and recently eliminated the top commander of its affiliate in Somalia. We've done so while bringing more than 140,000 American troops home from Iraq, and drawing down our forces in Afghanistan.
Without the determination of World War I poets, people who didn't take part in the war wouldn't have been able to understand the devastation caused by it. The Great War resulted in more of a loss than a win for any country. The amount of lives taken from the fighting serves as a lesson about war to the future. Although Sassoon wrote hundreds of poems about the war, he didn't have much of an impact at the time. His impact is found more at a long-term scale by the way war is now viewed and executed. Just 20 years after the end of the Great War, World War II began. Sassoon, who worked so hard to try to stop brutal violence, had to witness the world tear itself apart again. Safe quit of wars, I speed you on your way, up lonely, glimmering fields to find new day.
Oh, Father, tell me, do we get what we deserve? Oh, we get what we deserve. And we're down, we go.